explainable. But finding an Agarya who makes a living by working with iron is a relief, and the first sign we have that perhaps the Agarya's knowledge of iron can be used in new ways. If the Agaryas are willing to evolve, adding the skills of an artisan to their identity as metal smelters, if they can create delicate figurines out of the iron they produce, this could create a market for their iron outside village hearts, like the appreciative markets that exist for metal crafts like Dhokra and Bastar wrought iron. And if customers are willing to pay well for the Agarya's iron, perhaps the fires of their furnaces can be lit again, if they still exist. The search continues, and this time we cross the border into Chhattisgarh. Akalgaria, a beautiful village situated close to a forest. This is where Sitaram lives.
अरे सीताराम जी कहाँ हैं?
वो नहा रहा है सर वो नल में.
तेरे बुला दो ना.
हाँ बुला रहा हूँ. ए बाबू. कोई साहब मिलने आया है चला.
हाँ पहला पहचान था पूर्वज में, वो लोहे के काम करते थे और दूसरा काम नहीं करते थे, हल नहीं चलाते थे. हाँ अब तो पूरा देखो, अब हल चलाना शुरू कर दिया, जमीन जाहिजात मिल गया, दे दिया सरकार, तो अब हल चलाते हैं, उसी को कुछ करते हैं थोड़ा बहुत.
The crisis of identity that the Agaryas are experiencing is very real. We asked Sitaram about their centuries-old tie with the environment.
तो इसको फिर जहाँ जहाँ है झाड़ तहाँ तहाँ वहाँ अगरिया पाओगे, जंगल के तीर तीर, बस जंगल को छोड़ते च नहीं है अगरिया. हाँ
अच्छा.
हाँ
ऐसा क्यों है?
हाँ भाई, अब उसका जीवन विस्फालन होता है जंगल के पास तीर में. जंगल में पत्थर है, लोहा का पत्थर, कोयला, इसी का बनाते हैं ये झाड़ का.
उसको काट देते हो आप?
सूखा को काटते,
सूखे झाड़ को.
सूखे झाड़ मतलब गिरे पड़े रहता है, उसको खड़े को नहीं गिराते हैं. हाँ. उसको इकट्ठा करके उसका कोयला गिराते हैं.
Sitaram says they no longer cut trees to make charcoal. Instead, they collect fallen sal branches and pile them into a pyre before burning. Like their gods Lohasur and Agyasur, charcoal too has a separate deity, Koilasur. After an hour or two, the men cover the wood with sand. Once it cools, the charcoal is ready for the furnace. But we still haven't found an Agarya with a furnace.
कोई लोहा गिराने वाला अगरिया हमें मिल सकता है? हमने बहुत गांव गए हैं.
हाँ.
सब बता रहे हैं कि हमने ये काम बंद कर दिया.
बंद कर दिए हैं ना, तो अभी वही भालापुरी में बताते हैं, मिल जाएगा.
भालापुरी में कौन कर सकता है?
वो धर्म सिंह.
धर्म सिंह?
हाँ धर्म सिंह, प्रेम सिंह,
ये लोग कर लेंगे.
हाँ कर लेंगे.
कहाँ पड़ता है?
गढ़ी के पास.
Sitaram is a wise man. He has seen the world with his own eyes. Unlike city-based experts, he doesn't have any romantic ideas about this craft. In the time of the princely states, he tells us, an Agarya's annual tribute to the king was a kilogram of iron. Today, when gigantic steel plants produce tons of steel every day, who will need the Agarya's kilogram of iron? The search for the Agarya's furnace brings us to Karna National Park. The destination, Bhalapuri village, not all too far from the lodge at Mukhi. After a continuous search for the Agaria's furnace, leads are beginning to dry up. It's becoming all the more important to document this dying craft that once revolutionized India's economy. Today is going to be the last day of our search. All leads have run dry, except for Dharam Singh and Prem Singh. If we fail to see the furnace, we will have to head home. With occasional tea breaks on the way, we continue our search for yet another obscure village, which hardly occupies any space on the maps we carry.
धर्म सिंह का घर कौन सा है?
ऐसे जाना और फिर इधर, फिर हैंड पंप मिलेगा उसके आगे, फिर इस साइड एक घर, उसके बाद उनका घर।
धर्म सिंह जी,
जी,
ये सीताराम ने भेजा आपके पास अकल घड़िया से।
क्या काम से?
धर्म सिंह has a firm belief in the shakti of virgin iron. He showed us a small piece which according to him can cure the greatest of illnesses.
ये अभी इससे कुछ बनाएंगे क्या? इसी को ऐसे ही इस्तेमाल होगा?
नहीं नहीं नहीं, उसको बना करके थोड़ा सा,
हां थोड़ा सा देंगे बना करके।
अच्छा, थोड़ा इसका टुकड़ा?
हां टुकड़ा।
अच्छा,
जो झाड़ने फूकने वाले वैद्य रहता है,
हां
वो जॉब करता है कि नहीं, मैं कुंवारी लोहा खिला तेरे को बंधेज करूंगा, रोगी साफ हो जाना चाहिए, रोग मतलब बीमारी खत्म हो जाना चाहिए, तो हम कोई इसको कीमत लगा के देते हैं।
तो कितनी कीमत होती है इसकी एक भाई टुकड़ा देने की?
इतना बड़ा तो टुकड़ा की 20 रुपए तो ले सकते
हैं। तो छोटा सी का
तो आपके पास कोठी देखने को मिलेगी?
हाँ जी।
तो आप किसके पास?
प्रेम सिंह के यहाँ।
After weeks of searching, finally someone who has a furnace. But will it work? Their elusive furnace. The koti, as they call it, is made up of clay mixed with rice husk. It's 2 to 3 feet tall and has 3 openings. One at the top to put the charcoal and iron ore inside, and 2 at the bottom, one to take out the slag and the other to fix a nozzle to blow air during the smelting process. The same opening is later used to take out the molten iron. The Patel family has now started with the final preparations. These final settings have to be performed with extreme caution. If anything goes wrong, the gods will be angered. Prem Singh, head of the family, meticulously inspects each step.
उसमें सर मतलब अंगूठी डालते हैं तो 4 गोटी गिराते हैं ना, तो गोटी अंगूठी को थोड़ा सा टच करता है तो भट्टी अपना सही है।
अच्छा, वो क्या कर रहे हैं आप इधर बताइए?
इसको जला करके वहाँ पर जला करके वो हम बिस्तर बिछाएंगे सर, तो वो फिर अंदर डालेंगे जिंदा का।
The nozzle is fixed to the furnace. Traditionally prepared by women, the heat-resistant materials they use are a well-kept secret. Do they know the science behind what they make? Or has it become a custom to be followed? 2 sacks of iron ore are broken into small pieces and roasted. This is then mixed with 20 kilos of charcoal. It will produce 1 to 2 kilos of iron after the Agarias work for 4 to 5 hours continuously. The design and shape of the furnace is crucial, as the heat retention depends on the right size and shape. The minimum temperature necessary to produce iron from these kinds of furnace is around 1200 degrees. But making of iron for the Agarias is not scientific. Over the years, their knowledge has morphed into myths and religious beliefs. Iron is not something they extract from the earth. It is a gift granted once Lohasur is appeased, Agyasur invoked, Koilasur consumed. And so, before the furnace can be worked, countless rituals must be performed. First, an unmarried girl needs to work on the furnace, and then the rest of the family can take turns. The incredible work the Agarias put into making iron is awe-inspiring. It's been 3 hours since they started, and according to Panku Singh, there are two more to go. The flame's color starts to change as the iron forms, from yellow to blue, as the temperature rises. This was the moment we all were waiting for. First they poke and make way for the slag to come out. And then, finally, they open up the furnace from the front to get at the iron. The fruit of all the intense activity of the night. 5 hours of relentless effort, and they have managed to extract a small piece of virgin iron. But they don't mind. Everyone is happy and ready to celebrate.
और ये काम कैसा लगता है घड़ियों का काम
ये तो बहुत अच्छा लगता है अब कर ही रहे हैं काम तो अच्छा ही लगता है
लेकिन अब तो छोड़ जाओगे ना मुझे लगता है
नहीं छोड़ेंगे नहीं करेंगे
कैसे
जैसे कर रहे हैं वैसे करना ही करेंगे
प्रेम सिंह सन प्रकाश 23 ईयर ओल्ड प्रकाश ऑलरेडी अ फादर ऑफ टू इज इलिटरेट बट डिटरमिंड टू सेंड हिज किड्स टू स्कूल सो दे हैव अ ब्राइट फ्यूचर बट विल इट इंक्लूड आयरन Today, iron is an important part of Agaria beliefs. Yet, for most Agarias, scenes like these will become rarer still as iron gets replaced with its derivative, steel. Our search for the Agaria will not be over until we meet the modern-day Agaria. Having finally seen the ancient process, we are curious to see how far we have come today. So here we are in Bhilai, one of the largest steel plants in India. Vivek Verma, senior manager of the blast furnace. Although in the business of making steel, his work would not be possible without the knowledge of iron. For steel is nothing but highly refined iron containing less than 2% carbon.
I'm coming from this remote place where I saw Agarias work for 5 hours and all they produced is 1 kg of iron. And here, they turn out 4,500 tons in one day.
Yeah, they are the ancestors of iron making, but their scale is totally different than what we are producing today. But the basics remain the same. The scales are different. It is as equal as, an aeroplane designed by the Wright brothers and an Airbus A380 today.
How big is this furnace?
This furnace is as tall as an 11-story building.
Here, everything is bigger, larger, and faster. But the basic principle remains the same. These batteries produce coke, which is the main fuel used in the furnace. This molten iron is purified and carburized to get the product that's building the entire nation, steel. It will be interesting to know what these modern-day Agarias feel about the entire process of steel making. Do they also have myths to tell?
What is the difference between iron and steel?
4.67% of carbon in iron is a kind of iron which we produce in the blast furnace, which is not very amenable to changing its shapes and giving you different kinds of things that you require. So what you have to do is to change that iron into something which can be formed. So what you need to do is reduce the amount of carbon that is there, and you do that by oxidizing a part of the carbon in steel making.
After spending time with the Agaria in the jungles of MP and Chhattisgarh, we are finally back with familiar faces who speak the same language. The language of science, of technology, of progress and prosperity. But there is some similarity between those illiterate villagers and these city engineers. They both respect the iron immensely. And maybe that's the reason that when Vivek speaks of steel, in his eyes, one can find the same spark as in Dharam Singh's. Meeting the Agarias, seeing their skill, means it's time to return home. Time to reflect on finding the Agaria. Little did we know that they weren't quite done with us yet. Back in Mumbai, the Agarias re-enter our world when Prakash calls. He's here, working at the construction site, laying the bricks that the iron his ancestors once smelted holds.
Bombay gaon chhod isliye aate hain ki gaon mein matlab kaam nahi milta. Kaam milta hai to kam paise milta hai, isliye Bombay aate hain. Aur sabhi rajyon ka aadmi jo hai na milte hain. छत्तीसगढ़ मध्य प्रदेश महाराष्ट्र एमपी बिहार जो भी हैं बंगाल के हैं ये सभी राज्य के मिलते हैं तो सभी अलग अलग भाषा का आदमी भाषा सुनना पड़ता है सुनने को मिलता है इसलिए आते हैं
Finding Prakash, an Agaria right here in Mumbai amidst the thousands who come to the city make us curious. What stories do the others have to tell? Do each of them come with their own talents? Are the strangers slipping past in the city men of iron or men of gold, men of ivory, men of marble? Who knows? And who will tell their tales? Who will explore their worlds? Mysterious, magical, and disappearing as they melt into the crowd.